Now, soon after the violence, elections were announced, and there was an upsurge of sympathy for Congress, and in particular for Rajiv Gandhi, the successor, and he was hailed by the people at large, by the Congress party, and even by the media, and most notably by the media, as the new hope, as Mr. Clean, as somebody who was going to symbolize the hopes of the youth, and so on and so forth. And he went on to win an unprecedented mandate, 400 odd seats in the elections that were held in towards the end of December. And by the beginning of January, his government was sworn in, and a senior Congress leader from Delhi was promoted to the cabinet rank, H.K.L. Bhagat, who was still then MOS. He became a cabinet minister, and another MP from Congress, Jagdish Titler, went on to become a minister, an MOS, for the first time ever. This was within weeks of the massacre, when wounds were still fresh. And in January, there was this very odd gesture of paying, the new parliament, paying tributes only to Indira Gandhi. There was not a word mentioned about the thousands who were killed in her name, in Delhi and elsewhere, in that resolution that was adopted by Parliament. It was talking only about the services rendered by Indira Gandhi and the tragedy that befell our country on account of that massacre. I mean, all that is true in its place. But then the people who are killed, the innocent people who are killed, or rendered homeless, or who became orphans, or who were raped, there was not a word of concern or sympathy for them in that resolution. And yet, when you see the contemporaneous reports, none of these oddities were reported or talked about in the media. The only people who were really protesting at that time, of course, the very great example set by people like Rahul Bedi and Joseph Malyakan, but they were really the exception. The rule in the media was they were eating out of Rajiv Gandhi's hands. They were all so full of him, so full of praise for this man, at a time when his hands were soaked in blood. That's the point I'm trying to drive home. And whenever there was any talk about an inquiry being held into 84 riots, he would very disdainfully say, no question of an inquiry, because it would only reopen old wounds, or words to that effect. Repeatedly he was asked, and this is the response he gave. And it was only after another round of elections took place in March 1985, elections to various states, and he won, he swept those elections too, you know, as part of that sympathy wave or whatever. It was only after that, when this massacre served this political purpose of reaping a harvest, electoral harvest, once in the election, in the Lok Sabha election in December, and then in the assembly elections in March 85, did the Rajiv Gandhi government finally deign to order an inquiry. And that was a commission headed by a sitting Supreme Court judge, Ranganath Mishra. And now, what did this man do? He, right at the first hearing, made it clear that he was going to hold all the proceedings in camera. In camera meant that no member of the public would be allowed to sit in the proceedings, and no member of the media also would be allowed to sit there. And so when he started conducting his inquiry, when witnesses started deposing before him, it was only because these witnesses were approached by some journalists outside the commission's premises, not very far from here, in fact, at Rajendra Prasad Road, where today have Indira Gandhi National Center for Arts. That's where, in one of those bungalows, was this commission's office. So when these witnesses would come out of the premises of the commission, journalists would approach them, and they discovered that you know, those who were deposing in those who were supposed to have given affidavits in favor of Bhagat and others, they all actually turned hostile. They had nothing to say in their favor. They ended up telling the commission that actually they did not sign these affidavits at all. They were given these affidavits, and most of these people were poor and illiterate. So they were given these affidavits by either Congress members or by policemen themselves, and asked to sign these affidavits saying that they were applications for compensation. They did not know that they were actually some long narrative about how Bhagat and company had actually saved them and done a whole lot of good to them, all that those false claims that were there. These people were unaware of it, and that's what came out during these proceedings. So when media started reporting this, despite that gag order from the Mishra Commission, Mishra Commission got very angry and then issued a further gag order saying that if these kind of reports continue to appear in the media, then I'm going to take action. Mind you, at that stage, at any rate, the Commission of Inquiry did not have any such power. It was only much later when there was a controversy in the context of Thakkar Natarajan.